Hello everyone, my name is Warren Fulgenzi, and today I'm going to be talking to you about a major problem here in the United States, and that is gun violence. According to Gun Violence Archive, there's already been 34 mass shootings in the United States in 2018. The concern is affecting many lives, many people. Today I'm going to be covering the growth rate of gun violence, school shootings, the effects, and how we can prevent it. The growth rate of gun violence is increasing every year. In 2016 to 2017, the rate increased by 11%. And some of the reasons why it's increasing is because of the exposure we have to young kids with violent movies, violent video games. Criminals are being sentenced to a minimum, and how easy it is to purchase a gun. School shootings are happening frequently every year. By this time last year, we had not as nearly many school shootings as we do now. And this is affecting our children. Our children are scared to go to school because of this reason. They don't feel comfortable, and school should be a safe environment for both students and teachers. Some reasons how we can prevent this is by making an effort on what we're showing our young generations. When they're young, they don't know what's right from wrong, and when we show them violent movies, violent video games, they think that's right, and we need to make an effort on showing them the right things. Another reason is we need to strengthen our gun laws in each state, and we need to help those who are mentally ill. We need to get them the proper help they need. And change doesn't happen overnight. It takes a while, but we need to start somewhere. And how we can start is with ourselves, how we can impact others. So I will be showing you a PowerPoint on some statistics of gun violence. So this graph was done in 2010, and it just shows how many people in the United States have guns. So 89 guns, there are 89 guns per 100 people, and obviously this statistic has grown. So we, right now today, we have more than 270 million people with guns. And the next highest is 46 million, and that is India. So this is a very big margin we have over India. By this chart, it shows how many gun murders there are per 100,000 residents, and the United States is up at the top. We have 3.61, and the next highest is 0.50, which is Canada. So there again, a big margin from the first to the second, and by this it's just a little scary by the numbers. So like I said before, gun violence is growing every year. So firearm injuries, in 2014, it was 11,338. It grown in 2015 to 14,000. And then it's grown to 2016, a little over 15,000. And last year, 2017, it was 17,000 area. Children under the age of 12 that have been shot, it's also grown every year. 2014, it was at 308. 2015, 390 children under the age of 12 were shot. 2016, 337. And last year, 394. Defensive gun use, you know, growing every year. 2014, 573. 2015, 660. 2016, 885. Last year, 1,140. So, I mean, the numbers don't lie. Every year, in each category of gun violence, it's growing. On an average day, 96 Americans are killed with guns. Out of those 96, 7 children and teens are killed. So just by the numbers, you know, every day, on an average day, 96 people are killed. 62% of firearm deaths in the U.S. are suicides. So I mean, this statistic right here, this shows that we need to help those that are we need to help those who are in need of help. We got to give them the right treatment so we can lower this 62%. And you know the. Like, again, numbers don't lie, and it's a little intimidating by these numbers, but we got to make a change, and we got to do it soon. So I found this picture, and it really speaks a lot. So a number of Americans killed on battlefields in all wars in history. So we've had a total number of 1.3 million killed in the battlefield, and number of Americans killed by firearms in the U.S. since 1968 is 1.5 million. So, you know, by this, we're basically killing ourselves, which is pretty sad. You know, we're supposed to be a tight country, but we're killing each other. But you know, we gotta make a change, and that starts with ourselves. And if we can change ourselves, we can affect those around us, and we can slowly decrease this rate. So I hope you all learned a lot from this presentation, and let's make a change. Thank you.